Hi, today let us discuss about room types or the various types of rooms available in a hotel. As all of you know that the competition is getting high and high day by day. In this competitive world, the hotels are trying to provide varieties of service. Among that, the room is one of the most important service which is provided to the guest. Let us see the various types of rooms in a hotel. Rooms are categorized and priced according to the type of bed, number of packs, decor, specific furnishing or features, special themes, etc. Let us see the various types of rooms available in the hotel. Single room. It's a term very familiar for us. Single room is a room with a single bed meant for one pax. A room that is for one person. Normally, the size of the bed will be 3 feet into 6 feet. Double room. Double room is a room with a double bed meant for 2 pax. The size of the bed may be 4 feet by 6 feet. The next category is twin room. A room with 2 separate single bed. This room is for 2 pax. As in the case of single room, the size of the bed is 3 feet into 6 feet. The next category of room is twin double room. This room is also known as double double room. This is a room with 2 separate double bed. This room is meant for 2 person to 4 person. The size of the bed is 4.5 feet by 6 feet as in the case of double room. The next one is triple room. As the name suggests, this is a room with 3 separate single bed. The size of the bed will be same as in the case of single room. This room is meant for 3 persons. Next we have quad room. Quad room is a room 4 person with 4 separate single bed with a size of single bed 3 feet into 6 feet. The another category which we can found in hotels is Hollywood twin room. Hollywood twin room is a room with 2 single bed, 2 separate single bed but having a common headboard. We are using these rooms maybe as a double room. We can just join the twin beds and we can sell this room as a double room also. Hollywood twin room is a room with 2 single bed with a common headboard. This room is actually meant for 2 person. The next category is parlor room. Parlor room or it is a living room. This is not usually used as a bedroom. It is a living room with seating arrangements only where the guest can entertain their guest. The next category of room is studio room. Studio room is a room with a parlor setup. A parlor setup in the sense a living room with sofa cum bed or studio bed where this sofa cum bed can be used as a bed in the night or the studio bed can be used as a bed in the night and during daytime this particular room can be used as a living room. The next room is suite room, one of the expensive rooms of the hotel. Suite room means a room with a living room and a bedroom. Bedroom may be one or more than one rooms will be there. This is one of the expensive rooms in the hotel. Now we have junior suite room. It is again a large room partitioned into a living room and a bedroom. The difference between suite room and junior suite room is in the case of suite room, it's actually 2 separate rooms. Living room and bedroom is separate. But in the case of junior suite room, a large room, it's partitioned to a bedroom as well as a living room. Lanai. It is a Hawaiian term for a room with a balcony that overlooks a garden or swimming pool. A room that is having a balcony which overlooks some good scenery is considered as a lanai. The next one is efficiency room. Efficiency room is a larger room actually with a kitchenette attached. Kitchenette means there will be a facility for cooking provision inside the room. Normally, this type of rooms found in motels or in residential hotels. Next type of room is a duplex room or duplex suite room. It is actually a room situated in 2 levels of the floor. The first floor, there will be a living room and on the next floor, there will be a bedroom. And these 2 rooms are connected with an internal staircase. This is also considered as one of the expensive rooms of the hotel. Next category of room is penthouse suite room. Penthouse suite room is a suite room that is located on the topmost floor of the hotel. A part of the room can be open to the sky or with a glass roof. Again, it is one of an expensive rooms in the hotel. Cabana. Cabana is not actually a room. It is a changing room which is situated or located near to swimming pool or beach, which is having a shower facility or with a changing facility. Interconnecting room. This is a room with a common wall and a common door. Two adjacent rooms with a common wall and a common door. These rooms can be sell separately, or in the case of families, maybe we can sell the rooms together. If you want to sell the room separately, we can just lock the doors in between. And if it's for the family, you can just open the doors and you can sell the rooms together to the family. Next category is adjoining room. It is a room with a common wall, but there is no connecting door in between. In the case of interconnecting, there is a common wall as well as a common door, but in the case of adjoining room, there is a common wall but there is no connecting door. The next one is adjacent room. It's nothing else, actually rooms that is close to each other is considered as adjacent rooms. That may be a room opposite, or that may be the next room. And the last room is hospitality room. Hospitality room, it's actually a room that is hired by a guest on an hourly basis to entertain his guest. That may be a parlor, that may be a banquet hall, or that may be a separate room. So I believe that you got a basic idea regarding the different types of rooms in hotels. Maybe the hotels, they are not directly using these names to recognize their rooms. They are having their own ways to recognize their rooms. Like for example, maybe for a double room they call us standard double. Maybe for a twin room they call us a standard twin. Or maybe for a suite room they call us executive suite. It depends. So these are the basic types of rooms, and that can be renamed as per the convenience of the hotels. Thank you.